My name is Rhapsody, and welcome back to Hearthstone Arena. Oh, absolutely lovely time we're going to have. We're going to pick a class, we're going to play the game, and we're going to get 5 trillion wins. I know we're capped at 12, but don't worry, we'll get to 5 trillion. You believe me, don't you? Don't you? We're going to have to go with Warlock. I think it's the least recently played of all these classes. And also, I've got way too many Paladin runs recently. Okay, we're going to be going with the Knife Juggler, because it's solid all around and doesn't require me to build a specific deck archetype around it. I like having a silence in my deck, but I don't know if I like the 4-drop that trades against a 2-drop. But then again, we can have a 5-drop that trades against a 2-drop. There's not that many good... See, if we were playing a class like Paladin, like Rogue, like Mage, like Shaman... Is that it? Paladin, Rogue, Mage, Shaman. I'm trying to list all of the classes. Oh, Druid. All of the classes that have a viable common 2-mana mech. So you've got, obviously, Snow Chugger, Anodized Bear Cub, Goblin Auto Barber, Shielded Mini, and... Whirling Zap-O-Matic. There we go. Damn, look at all these fucking skills, son! Yeah, if we had a 2-drop that was like that, I'd totally go for it, but we don't. I think I might actually take the Antique Healbot. If we're going to be tapping to try and get some power... more cards than our opponent. We're definitely going to be hurting for health. And if they just start pushing face at some point, we might want to just throw down the Antique Healbot and go, no, your strategy is void and null. Void Caller, specifically speaking of Void... I'm going to be going with the Void Caller, just because dope as card. I like the Captain Yawmonger. I really like the amount of health that it has. Floating Watcher versus Spellbreaker. We already have a Void Caller, so Floating Watcher is incentivized. Raging Worgen, Silverback Patriarch, Dalaran Mage. Only one of these that's even vaguely playable is the Raging Worgen. Silent Knight, Abusive Sergeant. I really like the Silent Knight. Surprisingly. 3-mana 2-2 I usually don't like, but the fact that it's stealth means your opponent can't trade up to it, so you always have the ability to use it to trade up. Against an Abusive Sergeant, so the only one here I'm not interested in at all is a Lowly Squire, because I don't want to tap on turn 2 just to have a 2-2 on the field. Yep, I'll take the Sergeant. Sorry, the Silent Knight. Imp Gang Boss is possibly the best 3-drop in the entire video game. None of those are particularly inspiring. Another Yawmonger, we'll do it. Doomguard. See a Doomguard, pick a Doomguard. Pitlord, see a Pitlord, pick a Pitlord. Succubus. See a Succubus, pick a Darkscale Healer. That's how that goes, actually. It's the exact ordering. So we want some early game. I'll take the Worgen Infiltrator. I'm going to try and rely on getting other 2-drops. Implosion is just an incredible card. Fearsome Doomguard. Fearsome Doomguard's a lot better because we have the Void Caller. But other than that, it's just like a different Captured Yawmonger, right? Worgen Infiltrator. We've been offered 2 Demon Fuses, by the way. We're never going to pick one. Giving an opponent a mana... Like, it's most relevant in the early game, and giving your opponent a mana crystal in the early game means, oh, well, we lose suddenly. Second Worgen Infiltrator. You know what? I have enough other demons that I want to call out. That... I'll go with the Worgen Infiltrator here. Boneguard Lieutenant, decent 2-drop. I never want to be hero powering on turn 3, unless, of course, I've got... a Worgen Infiltrator and no 3-drop. Okay, might happen. Might happen. Unlikely. Whenever I target a minion with a spell, that's never going to trigger, because I'm never going to do that, unless I want to implosion my own Dragonkin Sorcerer so that I can buff it by 1 attack. Oh, that's incredibly good. So it's going to be Burly Rocks or Trog, even though I do like getting a little bit of a setup for Dragon Synergy. Dark Bomb, always Dark Bomb. See a Dark Bomb, pick a Dark Bomb. Sunwalker is pretty good as well. We actually have a surprising amount of late game so far. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we have 7 cards here. We could probably get that Armored Warhorse charge. Abomination is really bad for us because we have so many things in the early game that will be affected by it significantly and badly. Think, for instance, anything from Implosion, anything from the Imp Gam boss, Knife Juggler, Worgen Infiltrator, Worgen Infiltrator. Like, we've got a lot of stuff that just doesn't work well with it. Armored Warhorse. I don't like juggling. I don't like gambling on it. We could take the Fencing Coach as like a 3-mana 2/2 draw card. That's not a horrible thing to do, but it's still pretty bad. If we had a lot more Inspire mechanics, that would be a lot better. I think it's still better than the Armored Warhorse that'll never trigger. In Gang Boss again. Tournament Medic is actually interesting. It turns our hero power to draw a card. It's as good as Justicar True Heart, but only while it's on the field. Second Floating Watcher. I'm not keen. But then again, I did just say Floating Watcher is effectively an Inspire mechanic, right? Whenever your hero takes damage on your turn, and our hero power does that. Fencing Coach makes the watching... It makes it a little better. I do like the Haunted Creeper. Oh, I love me a Soulfire. I've got enough of a chunky late game that I don't have to worry about getting another 6-drop. Soulfire is good removal. Pilot Destroyer is an amazing 4-drop. Okay, now we're kind of getting in the swing of things. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 early game plays, but another Haunted Creeper is completely fine because it means that I can hold off on the Soulfire and Dark Bomb from being early game plays. Oh. I really want the Hrothgar now. Hrothgar trades up. That's the really good thing about Hrothgar. Hrothgar, sure, you take a lot of damage, right? But you can trade up easily against an opponent's 3 or 4 drop, which is incredible. I think we're going to have enough things on the field that we are actually probably going to get a decent benefit out of the Storming Champion when it comes out. Another Imp Gang boss, because Imp Gang boss is the best card in the game. Another Imp Gang boss, because Imp Gang boss is the best card in the game. Siphon Soul for removal, because you never have removal as a Warlock, and that's our deck. Let's have a look through this. We've got way too much late game, but we do have the ability to sustain ourselves in late game. We've got a heal from the Antique Healbot. We've got a heal from the Darkscale Healer. We've got a heal from the Siphon Soul. We've got strong removal. We've got amazing 4-drops. We've got amazing 3-drops. We've got amazing 2-drops. I would be surprised if we didn't at least go 8 wins, which is probably the most ambitious prediction I've made in a while, but also not that far away from my average, which at the moment is like 6.25 per run. Alright, cool. This looks like a pretty good deck. Alright, let's get down to business. To defeat the Huns, of course. Assuming that all of the opponents we're going to be fighting are Huns. Except for the ones that beat us, like, you know, the Flamestrike Mages. How are you going to have 4 Flamestrikes in a deck post-TGT? I don't get it! Of course, I'm conveniently forgetting the fact that I had a Flamestrike Mage that had 3, so... Whatever, I guess I'll forgive them that. I wish the Hrothgar showed up earlier so I could justify picking it. I really like that card. You asked for it. Your soul shall be mine. Imp Gang Boss is good enough that I keep it. Is it good enough that I keep it in my opening hand without getting a 2-drop? I don't think so. With 4 cards that I'm mulliganing and 4 Imp Gang Bosses in my deck, I'm relatively likely to get one anyway. Now you might be thinking, Rhapsody, what is that delightful looking mug that you're drinking from? Excuse me. Am I gonna have to go 2 cards down on that? I'm not gonna do it yet. You might be thinking, what is that delightful looking mug that you're drinking out of? Are you having like a Starbucks coffee or some shit? No. 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 Please. No. Ooh, hang on. What's my opponent's ping? This doesn't trade yet, but... It will eventually. No, this is a mug. Can you read that? Oh, no, wait, it's mirrored, of course, because the camera is mirrored. It says, the great indoors, then it has a picture of a remote, a sandal, a fireplace, and a shower. I like it. In the same style that you would usually find a crest that says the great outdoors. Oh, it's art. It's comedic-based art. Okay, I have a lot of late game stuff in my hand, so I'm gonna try and get that stuff out, and here's how I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna make it super likely that I discard one. Boom. I need to get the tempo. My opponent played a 1-drop and then a 2-drop, and then another 2-drop, sure, but they stuck roughly to their curve. I cannot believe that I don't have a Imp Gang boss.
Knowledge is power, and I know a lot.
Okay. Now, I don't want to reveal this just in case my opponent... Like, first off, it gives my opponent something to ping so they can start building up the power from their Dalaran Aspirant. But secondly, what if they ping this and then Flame Cannon in order to kill this? That's 4 mana and they get to clear. That's a horrific future that I don't want to live in. Attack, attack... Darkscale Healer, 3-3 and a 4-3. Or attack, Darkscale Healer, 3-3. No, Blizzard's too bad if I do that. Alright. This is fine.
The gates are open.
Oh, that's not fine anymore. At least my opponent traded. How bad do I want Flamestrike to be for me? Not that bad. That's very good. Because now, even if Flamestrike happens, I'll have the ability to take down the Lord of the Arena. And have an established board, it's all good. It's my captive Yawmonger. Wouldn't be super surprised to see Flamestrike attack here. Our opponent having that zombie chow really threw us off. Plus all the late game that we drew like four. There's the blizzard that I told you was going to happen. We drew a lot of our early drops. Sorry, our late drops. 2 7s and a 6 in the opening hand. That's pretty bad. Although it can also be said that I was pretty much asking for it with my deck composition. You definitely have a flame strike. Burly Rockjaw Trog is completely fine. Attack. Silence. Damn. I have a really good board. One flame strike kills most of it. But the really important thing here is that both of these have 6 as their health point. Okay. It's kind of bad. That's actually a really good split for me, though. Oh, that doesn't work out well for you. Okay, I'm not going to gamble on that getting all 4. So I'm going to attack here. This. See? I was exactly correct about how many I could expect from that. Tap so it doesn't die. Sure, this means that Frostbolt Fireball will kill me, but if you were holding that the entire time and not using it to remove important minions, then congratulations, you win. Flamestrike does leave me with 1, but relative necessity. Oh man, suddenly I've got a really good board. You. There we go. Okay, I screwed up the positioning a little there. I have to stop tapping, of course. I screwed up the positioning a little. I wanted to separate my highest power minions so the Cone of Gold can't hit both of them. I didn't manage to do that particularly well. Okay. You go first. I guess I'm fine with that. Oh! Probably should have tapped first, I guess. Whoops! I knew I was going to tap that turn as well, because I had the Antique Healbot in hand, so I should have tapped first. That's why you always use all of your draw... Like, you plan out your turn. If your turn includes drawing a card, if you can, you draw that card first. So you can reevaluate how powerful your turn can be. Important. Otherwise, I'd be able to Raging Worgen and attack face. I have Lethal on board. Tapping means that Fireball can kill me. I'm not going to take the risk. I don't need to take the risk that Fireball ping kills me.
Well played.
Yep. That's game right there.
Everyone,
get in here! No. And then let's just quickly kill them off. Give them the sweet release of death. Excellent. So there is a perfect example of the reason why Warlock is strong in Arena. Or when Warlock is strong in Arena, that's why Warlock is strong in Arena. To correct myself. You can make plays in the early game that are supremely anti-value, and then because you can use your hero power in the late game, and 2 mana out of 10 mana doesn't really cost you anything. 2 mana on a turn where you only have 2 mana costs you your whole turn, whereas in turn 10, it only costs you 20% of your turn. God damn, I am horrible at math.
Gul'dan versus Jaina.
So you can suddenly start getting back all of that value that you had to trade away earlier. I'd love to keep the Stealth Knight, but I don't have a 2-drop. I guess I should have kept that. Oh, hello, Silent Knight. Sorry, Stealth Knight. Sorry, Silent Knight, but I'm going to call you Stealth Knight. Stealth Knight, because you don't have the silence mechanic. So I feel like it would be disingenuous to call you the Silent Knight. Okay, not a particularly huge fan of that card. Suddenly I'm a much bigger fan of that card. Got a perfect way to deal with it. If I top deck, I just want in-gang boss in the early game. That's all I want. That's all I've ever wanted. That's all any human could ever aspire to having. Oh well. I put this in the center so Cone of Cold won't affect me. Although my opponent can't use Cone of Cold this turn anyway.
First kill.
This has a Divine Shield, so it doesn't matter how much damage it takes on its first hit. And the 2-1 dies regardless of whether it hits the 1-2 or the 2-3. If Implosion is my only 4-drop, Implosion is a 4-drop I'll play. Or, instead... No, I want to put it on this side. It shouldn't really matter. Interesting. I have a card to play. Dang it. Okay, it's fine. And here. I'm just trying to think how I space things out, because Implosion will always summon the imps on this side of the field. So playing around Cone of Cold means that I want all worthless things here and then a super powerful thing way over on that side. So that leaves me the ability to Implosion and then super powerful thing goes over. Suddenly, I want to keep the implosion.
This is my responsibility.
Silence!
I think I can afford to hit the face here. You would have removed that last turn before it could start to grow, if you had removal for it. Yep. So the fact that they ran that into that basically means that I managed to get a free amount of mana. Free amount of mana? What am I talking about? A free 6 damage on the opponent's face. Cool.
This is my response.
Silence!
I was considering double hitting that as well. So Flame Strike wasn't so bad. Just what I should have done. At least I can kill it now. Still not bad. Still definitely not bad. I can get so many knives out of this Knife Juggler on the turn that I play it. So many knives. Okay, that ping was always going to happen. Minion worth implosioning, please.
Must cleanse the sun well.
Well, looks like I'm going to be implosioning this minion then. Got a lot of damage on board. Interesting. Hey, 3 is exactly as many as I could support on my board. That breaks, and then I can only hit one. Weird.
Justice shall prevail.
Still have to do it. It only summons one. Now I've got a 50-50 to kill. Wow, or not. Excuse me? Tap. Hang on. Fuck, I had lethal if I tapped first. God, I knew I was gonna draw! Why did I not tap first? That's the second time it's fucked me this arena. Well played, though. I like it when opponents do that. Harakiri with something cool. Warriors do it a lot with weapons. They just run into a minion too big for them to handle. Rogues do it a bit as well. Shamans a little as well. Mages only do it if they have Fireball, Frostbolt, or one damage... or one health, so they can ping themselves. That's a really sad thing about paladins. They don't really get to Harakiri that often. RIP paladins. Okay. Druids do it a little because of their hero power, though. You also might have thought, so what are you drinking from that coffee mug? Is it coffee? No. Are you kidding me? Seriously? Why would I drink coffee out of a coffee mug? That's so... predictable. I'm drinking a different caffeine drink, at least. Oh, shit! We may want to just hold on and coin an Imp Gang boss into an Imp Gang boss. In fact, that's almost certainly what we want to do, unless we top deck a 2-drop. Nope. Cool. Hold off. This is going to be so difficult to deal with. Stop yelling! Exactly! Why are you always yelling? Why are you always yelling? Dravoon? What have you got? Ooh! Man, that's a powerful minion. If only I had a way to deal with it. Okay, I run there because the 1-1 poses a threat to kill either the Divine Shield of that or the minion here. Blessing of Kings, Truce of a Champion, Consecrate. Truce of a Champion. Okay. It had to be one of them. I'm just glad this is difficult for you to deal with, Paladin. You absolute twat. And then that dies. Sorry, spoiler alert, just in case you weren't aware. That dies. Ooh, Void Caller. Don't mind if I do. Feel free to do it. I'd love you to do it. Hilarious fun for all involved, except you, I guess.
So many viewers.
Battle cry card? Dancing queen.
That was a mistake.
Let's try and make him think that was my only demon in hand. We're playing the mind games, right? We don't have to be a priest to get right inside this person's brain. Alright, I'm already scared. I'm officially scared. Oh, thank you for not being the most powerful minion you could have been. I'll play. This needs to die first, because that's almost certainly Avenge. Which means that that attacks first, so that this then attacks. And then it summons its 1-1 and kills another thing. Boom, Avenge. Of course it is. Boom. 33% chance. Oh, come on. Double face. Oh, it would have been better if it was anything else. That was an 11% chance to not hit any of the minions there. I just want you to know that. I want you to know this when I'm all alone. Consecration. Attack here. Consecrate. Ruin my life. Storm and Champion at least comes out powerfully. Oh my god. Lay off it, you fucking Muppet. Hey, this goes face, just to test. Bit of secret. Oh, it's time to give this another buff. Huh? Okay, it's not the right... Whoa, excuse me. It's not the right buff. You need Consecrate to kill it. Yeah, well, you need Consecrate to fuck my board. You need one damage at all to kill this. It's a pretty good hero power. I don't blame you for stealing it. Oh, that's not what you wanted. That is 100% not what you wanted to be doing. We don't have that many sources of one damage in our deck. Sideshow Spell Eater needs to die, unfortunately. I have to trade. But I want to clear the board. So I hold off on the other ones because this puts 6 damage on the field rather than 5. It puts 2 different minions on the field, both of which can reinvent themselves as well. So removal isn't as powerful against it. But also because I can capture Yawmonger hero power next turn. That's another sideshow spell either. Just in case you forgot what that card is, I'll just name it for you. Sideshow Spell Eater, actually. Ooh. Implosion. That means I only have to trade one minion against that. Implosion is way better than any other card that I have right now. Pit Lord is never getting played. I'll trade that. I don't want to try and get many more 1-1s out of this when I can just do this and keep this around for a second. I'm going to have to stop tapping. Unless I get an antique healbot at some point. Kvaldia Raider is pretty bad. That's a really good hero power to have when you have the Kvaldia Raider. 2 damage or bust. Boom. Oh! Why, hello. Kvaldia Raider defeated. Unfortunately, my opponent has my hero power and not my same stress of having to keep yourself alive. It's much easier for a paladin to keep themselves alive. They have more heals. They just have more cards that heal them. I should keep tapping at least until I've got the removal card in my hand. What's the removal card that I'm thinking of? Siphon Salt. Okay, so we currently have 8 damage on field, 11 damage total, have to tap. Sunwalker is really good. I will go for the damage to base rather than hitting this. Because trading a 2-1 to kill the Divine Shield of this, it's fine with me. But if I run in there, then my opponent uses a Consecration to kill a Pit Lord, a Antique Healbot, and the Divine Shield of a Sunwalker. That's pretty brutal. It also opens up the avenue for them to misplay by playing... see? They can heal themselves more than I can. 12. I have 12 damage. I have 15 damage. I have 12 damage. Ooh. Hello. Should have tapped first. Luckily it doesn't matter. But still... regardless of whether it ends up mattering, it's still wrong that I didn't tap first. This is... see, shielded mini-bot True Silver Champion opening is pretty fucking bad. Doesn't matter what happens on the rest of the turns. It's pretty fucking bad that my opponent had that. Right. Hey, they did have the Consecration. I'm glad I played around it. I don't have damage for lethal. So I'll have to remove. There's no way you're top decking lethal here. Or almost certainly no way you can even top deck the ability to survive. Draw through your whole deck? Feel free. Just fatigue. Draw through the whole deck and start fatiguing. Both of these are Divine Shield. Divine Shield. What am I talking about? Divine Fail. I'm not going to dig around. I'm just going to finish him. But yes, Shield of Minibot, True Silver Champion. It's a really good opening. But. Big ol' but right there. It really doesn't matter if your opponent is just generating too many 1-1s to deal with. I think it was also very important that we chose correctly with which target to hit with our first Imp Gang boss there. Because otherwise it would have been a 2-3 and a 2-2. My opponent would have used their hero power, they would have killed the second 2-4. I would have had a 1-1, a 2-2, and a 1-1. The 2-3 runs into the... it wouldn't have made a difference. Okay, I was wrong. That looks like a curve to me. I'll keep Soulfire just in case some bullshit goes on in the early game. Especially because I'm going to be playing a 2-drop that really doesn't do that much. And also, if I mulligan Soulfire, what am I going to draw? Fucking... Captured Yawmonger? Probably. Wanna blow something up? Yeah, I do, actually! Whoa! Comet on the face damage there, buddy! Cool your jets, friend. We're just here to have fun. Don't worry, loves. The cavalry's here. Oh no, the cavalry's here. Is that going face? That's going face. I'm not a huge fan of what's happening right now. Just watch as I get Shrek'd by Fan of Knives. The card you usually don't really care about picking up, but my opponent definitely has it. Or is it going to be Hero Power Blade Flurry? Neither. That's not good for you. I'm looking at my play this turn and I'm thinking Haunted Creeper Soulfire. Or Void Caller Coin Soulfire.
I wonder.
Okay, that's exactly the... Like, that is literally the best card in my hand that I could have lost. Whew. That was a little too tense for a moment. So my opponent is ruthlessly going face. If they've got charge minions and they're going face the entire time, I have to assume they have cold blood. So one of my huge, huge win conditions here... Well, it's not even a win condition. It's a survival condition. Is I'm considering coining out the Sunwalker next turn... Just so that my opponent can't get through. Yet. Sorry, let me just finish that sentence with a yet.
Don't worry, loves.
The cavalry's here. Yeah, I have to kill everything on my opponent's field. Is there any way to do this better? Nope. Okay, let's just hope we get that antique healbot sometime soon.
For Blackwing.
Oh, fuck me, dead. That's not friendly. Wowzers. You gonna play another one of them? Please don't. So I've got a Doomguard in this deck somewhere, apparently. Oh, if I top deck it. Top deck Doomguard, play both the Imp Gang bosses, trade this into a minion, get the Doomguard. Oh, man. Now that's a good play. I'm sacrificing it entirely just to get the Pit Lord out. Also because I did need one more damage to actually clear the minion. It was unfortunate that I had to trade in the way that I did, but this allows me to actually get things on the field right now. No bar. Anything else you play is forfeit. Yeah. I do have to tap, unfortunately. Because I need to get closer to things like Siphon Soul and the like. So I put this here so that Betrayal isn't so bad. So you can't betray this in order to hit this. Yeah, that's a really good card. Luckily, I can double dip it with the Imp Gang boss and get a shitload of 1-1s. Sorry, Shedload. Oh, that was tense. Okay.
First.
I'm not going to go for the tap. First off, because guard is probably going to be wasted. I'm hoping that it's a 5 or lower amount drop card so that I can play it and then Doomguard next turn. And Doomguard without discarding any cards from my hand. But also because the health stat, it's too low. My opponent's been putting charge cards in their deck. They've definitely got more charge cards and they've definitely got a Cold Blood or something. Or a Vis.
Don't worry, loves. The cavalry.
Charge card. Cold Blood.
We are the
Shadow Pan Rider. That's pretty bad. That's pretty bad. Okay. Loading one shot is pretty good. Three, three, five, 11. My opponent would be dead if they didn't have that antique healbot. I'd just like to note at this point. Okay, I'm gonna have to use the Doomguard plus a 2-1 to take that out. Maybe that should have gone face. That definitely should have gone face and that should have gone to that. That's my bad. That is entirely my bad. That is entirely my bad. That puts it on really bad health points, because it's easier for a rogue to deal 1 damage than it is for a rogue to deal 3. 3 is a difficult health point for a rogue. Well played. I'm glad I won it, but that last play was very questionable. Oh, you know what I should do? I should probably reroll some of my quests. Druid and Hunter. Now watch and learn. Let me just, let's just quickly watch Ratchet 6-130 do a match. No, okay, I'll continue in the arena. I'll do that afterwards. Oh, I've run out of juice. Okay, I can't get the cap back on this. That is an outright shame. It's okay, though. Everything in perspective. It's not the worst thing that's happened, ever. I mean, the dinosaurs went extinct. That's pretty bad. There was that whole Cold War thing. Wasn't fun either. The cap just edges out the Cold War, though. Still pretty bad. Mandubala. I want to keep the Void Caller, but not unless... I'm going to regret this. I'm going to regret this unless I draw a 3 drop on the top deck. Suddenly I regret this a lot less. Because now I can go this into Bone Guard, into Void Caller with the coin. Ooh, that's really bad for me. Never mind. So now I'm mostly scared. Oh my god, excellent. I was thinking, oh, I can hit the face, because what if they don't have a 3 drop? I mean, blah, blah, blah. Excellent. I'll actually hit the face with this. Because if they do hero power to kill this turn, I mean, my assumption is they're going to have to silence this. And they're going to have to silence this if they have the Keeper of the Grove. Right. Oh, shit, yeah. Oh. Okay, I have to gamble. Oh, it got the right one. And then I play that, and then I tap. Casual turn 4, 3, 3, 6, 6. Druid of the Claw does nothing. It dies the Floating Watcher instantly. Whew. Sorry, I'm just enjoying myself a little too much. This is a good arena. I'm having fun. I'm having a lot of fun. Do you have swipe? Swipe doesn't even get you back on the board. Swipe makes the board a little less painful.
Not for one.
That's so, so painful to watch my opponent have to do that.
I'm watching you.
Oh man. Excuse me? What just happened? They all missed it. My opponent healed by 8 by taking 4 damage.
Magic detected.
What the fuck was that?
Bathe in flames.
Whoa. It's obsessed with the face. Okay. This is the last chance. It just needs a hit. Thank you. Okay, so I wanted to keep the Siphon Soul that turn rather than using it on the 5-2. First off, using it on 5-2, not a great thing. But my opponent's now on the turn where they can play a Ironbark Protector. Okay, 5-0. That one was pretty low effort. Just got those Inspire triggers off, yo. So, Warlock. I think my Warlock average at the moment is 7? Gosh, I should really keep my averages up just over here. This is my second screen, you can't see it, but over here in the corner so that I can actually read them directly, because every single time I'm like, oh, what's my average going? But then again, I'm only, what, this episode is 235? I'm only 35 arenas into my new set of data.
Gul'dan versus Malfurion.
So it's not a huge sample size. I'm so tempted to keep the ink. Oh my god, I want to keep everything. I'll keep the Imp Gang Boss. Because if I get another Imp Gang Boss, I can do the coin Imp Gang Boss, Imp Gang Boss, Imp Bang Boss. This is incredible. I've got a one drop. I've got a coin Imp Gang Boss. Don't trigger. Don't you freaking dare. Come on, man. I have all of my 7 drops in my deck. Absolute bullshit. Okay, here's the part where they play Bomber, and Bomber hits their own Gadgets and Jouster 3 times. Are you ready? Are you ready? Hang on, it didn't happen. Okay. They don't have the ability to, well, they don't have the ability using a Druid of the, what's it called? 4 mana, 2/4, choose 1, deal 2 damage or silence. I can't recall. But they can't do that.
What to do?
What are you going to do with your hero power this turn, buddy? How is that going to help you? Slow you down a lot. True. But it just spawns 1/1s. Oh, you know, I know what you're trying to do. You're going to go double trade hero power, kill one of them, so that I have to double trade my board to kill yours. Is that it? Is that your plan? Okay, that's a lot of face you're doing there, buddy. I have to warn you of the health risks of going face. Probably Raging Wongan Soulfire next turn. Swipe. It's pretty bad. Yeah, especially because the 2-1 was still in stealth. Oh well. Can't really soulfire one of those. My opponent's gonna have to hero power and trade one of the minions into it so that I can't use it to kill both of the minions. Swipe is actually the best clear against that board state that I have.
The great outdoors.
Mana? Card. Come on, that's all of my seven drops! My whole hand is all of my seven drops. And you know what's going to happen. I'm going to use Soulfire and it's going to discard the only non-7 drop in my hand, whatever that's going to be at the time. Okay, here we go. 25% chance for amazing things. All that could happen. That's cool too. See, I really wanted to go with the implosion this turn because implosion sets up for an amazing net. Oh my god, you're gonna swipe my face. Stuffle. Similar enough. So my opponent's doing all this removal. They're not getting an incredible amount of face damage in, but they are getting enough. I can no longer tap. Here's all my early game cards. Oh. Double Imp Gang Boss got shrecked. Actually, the other one that would have been really good against the Double Imp Gang Boss would have been Mind Control Tech. It's okay, I guess. Well, I'm probably dead next turn. Ooh, Siphon Soul. That'll keep me alive. Just watch. Yep. You know those minions I needed to rely on in the late game because I didn't get it? Swipe to the face and then another swipe to the face? Yeah, I was never winning this game. Okay, 3 swipes, a Starfire, a Starfall. We played a mage, basically. Basically, they were a mage. And of course, the gadgets and joust are on turn 1, getting the gadgets and joust. It's pretty good. Oh well, you win some, you lose some. Or in this case, you win 5, you lose 1. It's close enough to the standard metric. Okay, how are we doing for time? 5:25 p.m. Excellent. Excellent. I have to be somewhere at 6:30 p.m. my time. To do some recording. I'm going to be recording a game called Keep Talking and Nobody Explodes. I'm going first. Dark Bomb is likely to be able to use for removal. Oh, or I could just Haunted Creep. Okay. It's okay. So I was thinking they coin a minion turn 1, then I get to Dark Bomb remove, and then I get to stick on curve. Ooh, play a standard minion. Living Roots. Okay, I've got a really good card against that. Haunted Creepy, eat some hardcore. I'm gonna quickly check if no one's looking for me.
It's time for a little blood.
Just had to make sure that the recording partners weren't looking for me. Because we recently, here in Australia, went into or out of daylight savings time. Whichever, honestly, I don't know, nor do I likely care. Holy shit. You don't want that many one health minions on the board when I've got this and this generating all my one health minions. And trade one. Cute. Very cute. Good thing I have this. So I attack the smaller one, because now if this attacks, I have to get another 1-1, and then something else needs to attack as well in order to finish it, so I get another 1-1. Whereas if I attacked there, all it takes is 2 damage from hand in order to remove this. And make me a sad panda. Okay. Roth is a good response. Roth, hero power, 2-1 to the face. I end up trading one of my 1-1s into that. All good. All good. I don't really have that much that I can generate this turn. I've got, like, off-curve stuff, I guess. Alright, I'll play the most powerful thing I can. Siphon Soul comes up this turn. If my opponent plays a Druid of the Claw, I'll probably just Siphon Soul. If they play something that's just got, like, high attack, nothing else really standing for it. It's probably Sunwalker. Okay, Sunwalker, definitely. Sunwalker, go face or Oak Brute? Face. Because there exists the chance that the Ogre Brute, like, the only one you can target against is this. So it's got a 25% chance to miss and go face, 25% chance to miss and kill itself on the pilotage. My play was based around the fact that you need the ping to kill the Divine Shield, so yeah, okay, never mind. I can't really afford to throw the Siphon Soul on that. And I couldn't afford to play the Void Caller because I didn't have a minion that could be summoned from it in hand.
I am undefeated.
Win the joust, here you go. Oh, you lost the joust! Incredible! I didn't even know that luck could happen to you! Okay. Logged.
Give me your
best. I should have done the trading first just in case this becomes... Oh! Well, that's unfortunate. Just in case it became Doomguard, in which case I don't want to have anything on the field. Luckily, it didn't. Okay, unless you have charge minions, you're only getting one card. Are you gonna sacrifice yourself? Really? You are? Interesting. So that's how much you want the card. You'll give me that, even though mine had charge. Okay. That's okay with me. It's entirely fine by me. I want to tap for this, but that's got to die. Hang on. 4, 5, 9. No, I don't have lethal. But I am tapping this turn no matter what I do, so I may as well do that first. Interesting. I could try and fill my cards, my opponent's hand with cards. My opponent's hand with cards. Yeah, no, that's correct. My opponent's card with hands would have been the incorrect one. This has just got to go face. Yeah. Hang on, this costs 3. I totally could have just played the captured Yawmonger.
Where shall I
Whoops. Alright, that's getting Siphon Sold. This is exactly what I needed. My opponent to think that they were safe behind a taunt. Siphon Soul, I have 3 damage on field. I have... Sorry, 8 damage on field, and I have Soulfire. I have Lethal. Well played.
Well played.
Whee! They concede? Okay. I was like, shit, I can't cast this. Did I run out of mana? Did I somehow fuck up? Did they concede? No. Never mind, they concede. Okay. 6-1. 6-1. Perfect amount. Oh. You know what game is amazing? Look, I know it's kind of bad etiquette. I'm playing Hearthstone, but I'm talking about a different game. But you know what game is fucking incredible? Darkest Dungeon. Have you played that shit? That shit is dope as fuck. Damn. So, story time. First time I played Darkest Dungeon, I wiped, right? It was like 4 minutes in or something. I was like, I don't like this map system. This is all random bullshit critical hits. I don't fucking like this game. It's bad, 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 bad. Right? That's me being grumpy. I'm so bad. I'm gonna try and keep these and go for an optimistic curve. Anyway. That's optimistic. That is optimistic. Anyhow, so I eventually wiped. And I say eventually, after 4 minutes I wiped in the tutorial. Yeah. It was pretty fucking bad. So then I stopped playing it for like 11 months. And then recently they released an update called Those From Below, which I believe was the Cove update. Anyhow, I picked a pack up and was like, all right, I'll give it one more shot. And then I played it, and I wiped in, like, my second mission, right? My whole party. And I was like, I can't fucking be bothered building up new people. I hate it. It's such a bad game. And then an hour after that, I launched it again. I don't know why, but I was like, I need to play that game again. So I launched it up, started playing again, wiped on the fourth mission. I was like, fuck this game. I can't believe came back to this game. I'm not going to give it another chance. Why would I give it another chance? 30 minutes after I closed it, I opened the game again and I went through and I ended up getting like mission 6 or something like that. And then half of my party wiped and I ran away. Cue repeat. Oh, fuck this game. I can't believe I'm playing this. Next day I woke up and I played it for about 6 hours. On and off. But it's incredibly engrossing. Okay, I got this. First. It's incredible. The more and more I play it, the more I realize that all of the random elements, the critical hits, the getting surprised in combat, the getting fucked over by curiosities, which are items you interact with, all of that kind of stuff, as long as you know a little about the game, you know more than you used to know about the game, so basically you just got to learn a bit. As long as you know a little bit more, you can totally avoid all pitfalls in the game. Or you can mitigate the horrible effects of them. Sure, you might get a critical hit out of nowhere, or you might get critically hit by someone else out of nowhere. But there's so many ways for you to actually play around that shit that it's almost never not your fault. So I attack in. Just because I can't guarantee that this will be able to trigger twice if my opponent does some, like, Truce of a Champion bullshit or something. It also means if my opponent attacks in here and then consecrates, I'm still fine. Yes. All in all, excellent video game. I'm considering starting a series on it. Like, I'm considering it very heavily, but it's one of those game... Did I go into Constructed? I must have clicked the wrong button. Am I in Constructed? No, I don't think I'm in Constructed. Weird. Okay. Uh-huh, obvious. So I need to get as many minions to spawn as possible. I can't rely on a 25, so I'm going to go for that. Could be excellent, could be horrible. Okay, I do need to hit that. have to give him the coin. Please. Please. I hate this video game. Why?
Right on time.
This fucking world's worst video game. I love it. I hate it so much. Oh yeah, now you know where the target is. Okay, so I have to throw... Oh, fuck, I did that in the totally wrong order. My bad, my bad. That was entirely my fault. Horrible ordering there. I should have sacrificed the 2-1 against the 5-5 and then run the Imp Gang boss in. Hopefully, this Cho is just stopping my opponent from being able to cast any of the spells in their hand. That's, like, my best case scenario. That fencing coach is getting so discarded. And then I tap, buffing you. Nasty. Okay, how am I gonna remove this Silver Hand Recruit? Imp Gang boss? Yeah, that's fine. I'm fine with this because that's not an amazing health point to hit, right? So Consecrate removes the Divine Shield from this and kills this. It's basically the best thing that Consecrate does. It also gives me a Consecrate in hand, so that's worth considering as well. Floating Watch a tap. Mm-hmm. Next turn is Floating Watch a tap again. So this, no matter what it hits, is going to go down in health to consecration range. But this doesn't need to be in consecration range as long as I attack with that one. Excellent. Consecrate. Give me a consecration. So you have to deal with the 6-drop this turn. Sorry, the 6-6, the 5-drop. Floating Watcher. You don't know how big it's going to go. Oh, you got a dragon in hand. A drake in hand. Okay, hang on. Let me check. Do we have lethal? 8. 10. Yes. I'm so happy. Whee! 7-1! Oh man, I think we're playing a lot better. I really do. Okay, this is officially bringing my average up. Definitely bringing my Warlock average up as well, which is good. By the way, if you're wondering why I keep talking about my stats, it goes into a story. So someone I know asked me once, "Hey, you play a lot of Arena, why aren't you getting better?" And it made me start to think, like, am I getting better? How do I know if I'm getting better? Can I prove that I'm getting better? So then I went through all of my videos. I already had the first 100 done because I tried to do stats a long time ago. But I went through all of my videos and I recorded the class and the wins and the losses for it. Because I really needed to know, like, am I getting better? Am I wasting, like... 200, 300 episodes worth of Hearthstone Arena where I'm just the same the entire time. And it turns out, no, I'm not wasting them. So my first time, ooh, that's not a good card to play. Wow. Really? First kill. Anyway. I really wanted to know if I was getting better. So I had to make the stats. And it turns out, yeah, getting a lot better. So the problem here is I really want to go for the 25% chance to kill it for free, but Imp Gang boss is too good. Also, if I do both of those, next turn I... Damn it. I didn't know I was going to sneeze until too late. Next turn, I have... cleanse the sun well. Actually, minions to play. Like, I can go Bone Guard Hero Power. I can go Bone Guard... Yeah, I can do... Oh, fucking hell. Why? Why are you missing all the goddamn time? Okay, you get played definitely. I'll actually play you. Because it's 50-50 to, like... Never mind. 50-50 to obliterate the opponent at that point. Trade the 1-1. I have just a perfect board. No consecration means in a really good position. That is 100%. Okay, that goes there. Yes. No? No, no, no. I tap and then attack there. Okay, that makes sense. That game goes. Gets the buff. And then it dies. So hoping for an early drop there. Anything I could have played would have just been incredible. At least my opponent also had to play off curve. If they played like a solid 5 drop there, I was probably out of the game. Floating Watcher attack. Soulfire. That's not bad. Here's why it's not bad. Next turn, I tap to make this a 6-6. I attack something, and then I can heal it back up after that, thanks to the Dark Scale, and develop a decent board. So if my opponent goes with one minion that isn't a Bald Fist Ogre, I win. Like this. That was really fucking annoying. That's really good. That's really good. Suddenly, this isn't a great minion. Okay, anything that's 4 or less is amazing. If my opponent tries to go for the trade, they're fucked, but... Sorry, if they try to go for the trade on the 2-2. This opponent. Look at how skilled they are. They're so skilled that they managed to draft a Dr. Boom. It's pretty skilled. Alright. That's pretty much rip me. I can't kill it this time. That's pretty much what you... That's pretty much what you need to do. You need to kill it the turn that it's played. I have to play 2 minions. So I may as well just play the strongest 2. Okay. We could survive. Could survive. If my opponent tries to go all face... We only need to top deck 4 damage to kill him. Which means that it's Doomguard or Bust. If they go for the trades, they don't really have any great trades proposed to them on the board. Now they've got amazing trades proposed to them on the board. It's really interesting how that changes everything. Oh yeah, okay, that's fair. Let's move quickly. Those daggers earlier. Those daggers. There's nothing I can do now. It's so over. The thing is, if this gets 3 triggers, that's like, draw 3 cards, play them for 0 mana while summoning a 1-1. Like, that's how the Inspire mechanic works. If it sticks around for long enough, you just can't beat it. It's definitely stuck around for long enough. I'm not interested in seeing how the rest of that game goes. I don't want to see how deep the rabbit hole goes on that one. Kind of sad. Any of those daggers went in a slightly better direction in the early game, we would have won. Some of those bombs went in a better direction in the later game, we would have won. Opponent got any... Any of the spare parts that weren't the plus one attack buff, we would have won. Wow. Okay, that's fair enough. Jihoko, mage.
You asked for it.
Your soul shall be mine.
Yep, keep the Dark Bomb just in case my opponent summons something that's really threatening the early game. Like if they go Gadgets and Jouster that hits, or... Actually, I can afford to do this in anticipation of them playing a card that I can respond to. The only play that this is really bad against is Frostbolt Flame Cannon. Which I guess, fine, mages are more likely to have than other classes. Unstable Portal player card. Excellent. Now I just Dark Bomb that. It's as though they just played a 3-2. This allows me to curve out a lot better. Because that makes this a 1, makes that a 2, 3, 4. And God knows I've got enough 5s. Just watch. Hit definitely hits because I missed the dagger. Mm-hmm. So I missed the 50-50, they hit the 50-50. They could hit the 50-50 and I could hit the 50-50. And it would be fine, but just because it went in that specific way, we're screwed. No reason to trade into that. The beautiful thing is there were so many good plays off the back of it as long as my knife juggler survived using the implosion. Uh-huh. That minion must have been silenced when it was played, because usually it says 50% chance to miss. But evidently theirs doesn't have that context. This is to prevent them from being able to ping this easily. Polymorph?
For the crusade!
Model worm. Interesting. Don't really want that Eam Gankpos in hand. Okay, so I'm free to do that attack because it means my opponent has two targets they want to ping. They want to ping off the Divine Shield and they want to ping this to kill it. But they probably don't want to do that because of how resolutely I'm like, yeah, fuck, feel free to kill it. You're only summoning your own demise. And since they were avoiding hitting it last turn, I can't imagine they're super keen on killing it this turn. Also means they can't kill this and then Flame Strike. They have to get through this in order to kill this. Because they'd have to kill this without using any mana. So they could Flame Strike. I can just summon the Floating Watcher and Hero Power next turn, but that's really uninspiring. Oh, they are going for the kill. Okay. Probably like a fireball in hand if we're gonna do that. Okay, nice, nice. It got the correct one. Polymorph? Kind of cold. It's not that bad for me. All in all, that's pretty damn good. As far as I'm concerned. 3-1 gets a trade into my 3-3, but that's the reality of the situation. Hope I get either a 2-drop or a 4-drop next turn so that I can play Implosion 4-drop or Implosion tap 2-drop. And then I can set up for the Stormwind Champion tap on turn 9, which will have all the minions to buff from the Imp Gang boss and the Implosion. I can't afford that to be vaporized. If it's vaporized, I need it to trigger on the Haunted Creeper or one of the Spectral Spiders. Because vaporize kills without dealing damage, which means I don't get the 1-1, which means that Stormy Champion's suddenly useless. If that goes face, Stifen Soul is a possibility.
What to do? What to do?
That's fine by me. Implosion likely kills it. Implosion's got a 66.6 repeater percent chance of killing it if it does that attack. If it does that attack, it's almost always going to be Soulfire. Oh, no, it can't be Soulfire because this has to attack face. It's earmarked for the face. That's Siphon Soul. Okay, that's actually interesting. That changes everything because now I have to do this attack. No, because now I have to Soulfire and not discard the Siphon Soul. Is there any way I can improve my odds on this? I'm using 7 mana. Yeah, I have to tap first. Okay. Interesting. Okay. So now it could be duplicate or effigy, which is really bad. Effigy. That sucks. That sucks a whole lot. Effigy when your opponent is in the late game and only has big cards is pretty fucking bad. Oh, man. This might be our third loss. I would not be surprised. We can use Implosion, but our massive buff for our imps is gone. It's dead. Also, our opponent still hasn't used a board clear, like Arcane Explosion, Blizzard, Cone of Gold, anything. Oh, Baron Geddon, never mind. That's the board clear. I was wondering where the board clear was. And I'm dead, yes? Implosion kills this, but then that kills all of my implosion things by attacking. Implosion probably kills this, I should say.
So many possibilities. That's
11 damage on field. Okay, if they have no damage in hand, I could live on 1 health until next turn.
So many possibilities.
Because this does nothing. It does 2-4 damage. Because the imps die. This gets to attack. Yeah, I'm fucked. I can't tap or I lose. I literally just outright lose if I tap. I die. tap, I go down to 13. Then that takes me down to 5. That takes me down to... Well, that doesn't take me down to 5. It takes me down to 6. That attacks, and then you just need to wait and I die. That was the best I could have hoped for. They had to trade there. I don't have another Siphon Soul or removal or anything in my deck. Yeah, that's it. 7-3. Effigy. Really annoying card. Especially in Arena. Man. Man, oh man. I'm still happy with it. Not as happy as I could have been, especially considering the amount of knives that went awry. That's okay. I got 5 more gold than I went in with in a pack. Excellent. Let's open that pack. It's a classic pack. I'm going to get a Sylvanas. Here we go. It's a rare Sylvanas. It's a common Sylvanas. Common Sylvanas. Common Sylvanas. And another common Sylvanas. Cool. Don't read the card names, by the way. They're all lies. They're all Sylvanas. You'll find out when I go into my deck collection. Let me just go into the... Oh, no. The button doesn't work. Oh, well. I'm just going to have to go back. Whoops. Never mind. My name has been Rhapsody. The name of the game has been Hearthstone Arena. The name of the deck has been... Shots Wide. I don't know if... I don't know how many of you have played XCOM, but... When you use a Rocketeer in that game and they miss their rocket shot, which is usually like a 90% chance, 80% chance, 70% chance. When they miss, they just say shots wide, but you can hear shots wide before the shot actually goes out. So you know that you fucked up on the audio cue. Anyway, that's how I felt a lot of the time with the Knife Juggler. Hopefully you've been enjoying yourself. If you have, please click like. It does help me get my content out to new people. There's also a playlist in the description down below with all my Arena, Hearthstone Arena, Adventures, Ranked, and Tavern Brawl, past, present, and future, including my Arena statistics down there if you're interested. Hopefully you've been enjoying yourself, and we will see you next time.